Good morning, ladies. This is Carrie from Fresno, California, and my website is www.florischapman.net. That's FlorischChapman.net. Coming to you this morning to start back up on our series on Hebrews chapter 11. It's on faith, salvation and faith. And I was going to start, I'm just jumping right in this morning because we only have 10 minutes on this video and I can't finish it all in 10 minutes, so I'm just going to touch the basics on it, and I'll probably have to do two or three videos on this one scripture. What I was planning to do initially was finish the Hebrews chapter 11 series today, and when I looked at it, I got stumped on the very first chapter. I was going to go from 28 to 40. And I read Hebrews chapter 11, verse 28, and I said, oh, there's just too much in this one verse for me to just pass over like that. And so what I did was I went through 28, 29, 30, all the way through 40, and I highlighted all the important words to me. So I will probably take these scriptures one by one if they have enough information that I want to pass on to you. Otherwise, maybe I can get through two or three at a time. I don't know. We'll see how it plays. I'm going to just go ahead and read the first chapter, first verse for you. And then I have gone through and picked up the other translations and decided to read them to you also because it's really interesting how many interpretations of the verse you can come up with. And it helps you understand and grip the main ideas of each scripture. Okay, this one is verse 28. By faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of the blood, so that the destroyer of the firstborn would not touch the firstborn of Israel. And that happens to be the New International Version. And then I looked up the King James Version. Through faith, he kept the Passover and sprinkling of the blood, lest he that destroyed the firstborn should touch them. And then I looked up some more versions of it. Okay, this is the New Living Translation. It was by faith that Moses commanded the people of Israel to keep the Passover and to sprinkle blood on the doorposts so that the angel of death would not kill their firstborn sons. This is the English Standard Version. By faith, he kept the Passover and sprinkled the blood so that the destroyer of the firstborn might not touch them. This is the New American Standard Bible. By faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of the blood so that he who destroyed the firstborn would not touch them. This is the International Standard Version. By faith, he established the Passover and the sprinkling of blood to keep the destroyer of the firstborn from touching the people. This is the God's Word Translation. Faith led Moses to establish the Passover and spread the blood on the doorposts so that the destroying angel would not kill the firstborn sons. This is the American, this is the Bible in basic English. By faith, he kept the Passover and put the sign of the blood on the houses so that the angel of destruction might not put their oldest sons to death. This is the Douay Rheims Bible. That's Douay/Rheims Bible. By faith, he celebrated the Pasch, P-A-S-C-H, and the shedding of the blood, that he who destroyed the firstborn might not touch them. This is the Darby Bible Translation, that's D-A-R-B-Y. By faith, He celebrated the Passover and the sprinkling of the blood that the destroyer of the firstborn might not touch them. This is the English Revised Version. By faith, he kept the Passover and the sprinkling of the blood that the destroyer of the firstborn should not touch them. And this is the Weymouth New Testament. That's W-Y-M-O-U-T-H. Through faith, he instituted the Passover and the sprinkling of blood so that the destroyer of the firstborn might not touch the Israelites. Okay. You see how different the different versions are. And the words I highlighted in that verse were Passover, sprinkling of blood, destroyer, firstborn, and firstborn of Israel. And so my first word was Passover, and my point of reference for that was on the internet. And I'm going to have this all printed down. It'll be on the internet. The guide and everything will be on the internet to go along with the video. So you can just print it out and follow along if you like. Or I won't be able to read it all, so to continue from where I leave off, you can go and print these out or just read them right from the internet. And I'm going to start with Passover. Passover is probably the best known of the Jewish holidays, mostly because it ties in with Christian history. The Last Supper was apparently a Passover Seder, S-E-D-E-R, and because a lot of its observances have been reinterpreted by Christians as messianic and signs of Jesus. Passover begins on the 15th day of the Jewish month of Nisan, N-I-S-S-A-N. It is the first of the three major festivals that, with both historical and agricultural significance. The other two are, spell them, S-H-A-V-U, apostrophe O-T, and S-U-K-K-O-T. Agriculturally, it represents the beginning of the harvest season in Israel, but little attention is paid to this aspect of the holiday. The primary observances of Passover are related to the Exodus from Egypt after 400 years of slavery. This story is told in Exodus chapters 1 through 15. Many of the Passover observances are instituted in chapters 12 through 15. The name Passover refers to the fact that G-D passed over the houses of the Jews when he was slaying the firstborn of Egypt. In Hebrew, it is known as Pesach, P-E-S-A-C-H, which is based on the Hebrew root meaning Passover. And I'm going to stop there, and you can look it up on the website and finish reading it, because I have, like, I think there's like four pages on that reference article. And then the next word was the sprinkling of blood. Excuse me while I look for my... Okay, sorry. Sprinkling of blood, and my reference on that came from the internet, and it's from Leviticus 17:11, Blood of Atonement. The only way God deals with our sin is through the blood of the Lamb of God. The very thought that the Lord God and sinful man are brought together in an intimate love relationship is expressed in the word atonement. Behind this word is the preposition that alienation and hostility have been overcome. Reconciliation and forgiveness are also associated with atonement, Romans 5 and 11. And I'm going to stop there because I don't have time to read it. It's two pages. But this will be on the website.